I'm Captain Jesse Francisco with Gulf Coast King out of Galveston, and you're watching Texas Coastal. I want to thank y'all for coming along with me today. Today is the day I go pick up my boat, and it's ready. Man, y'all don't even understand how excited I am. I'm trying to get through this traffic and hurry up and get down there. It's been about a month since I had my boat, and man, it's just crazy. So, you know, had to do some maintenance and went down for a little bit, but, you know, gonna get back out here on this water and can't wait, man. Like I was saying, I ain't had my boat for, man, a month or so. So, you know, I haven't been out here on this salt water, but we're gonna get out here and give it hell. Man, it's been a while since I had my boat, guys. Been a while. Heading out to the boat ramp. It's about 4:40 in the morning. We're gonna get out here and try to get on these flounder. All right, guys, made it to the launch. About to put this boat in the water. About to put the boat in the water. I need y'all to see how foggy it is this morning, man. All right, guys, we just now heading here over Seawood Park. You got a couple waders in the water, and look at this line, brother. Look at this line of people trying to get these flounder, because today in the state of Texas, it's opened up, right, Chris? It opened up today, right?
Today.
And these guys, you know, we're gonna get in here kind of shallow, guys. We might wade, I don't know. We're gonna see if we can't catch them from the boat, and if we can't knock them dead from the boat and trolling motor, and then we'll get in. But other than that, man, we'll get back with you. Look at all these people, man. A lot of people out here. And what I'm doing, guys, is keeping this rod tip kind of high so I can keep that bait above that flounder's head and just kind of working that bait back to the boat. Want to do is I give a demonstration when one touches it. They just want to look at it wrong. We about to get it in. let it just look at it, you know. We about to get it in. All right, here we go, guys. That's the first one on. That little bitty potato chip. A little bitty potato chip. Get it in. I told you bit though. I felt it. Okay, look. Chris about to wait. He about to wait it out. See, he got one. He pulling on it, and he about to lay down. Bam.
Got him. Up against the rocks, man. I mean, literally, like in a foot of water.
Look at you. Look at you, boy. Look at you. Go on, throw it in here. Flippy. There we go. Yeah, they're up against the rocks.
I like
it,
like,
yeah. Yes, sir. Hey, Chris, what we're going to do is we're going to put those in the live well in the back. So I'll get this aerator going for you, okay? I'm going to just sit this down. It ain't going to go nowhere.
All right, fellas. I had another little thump. I'm going to give it a second. Some people like to count to 10. Personal preference. Sometimes I count to 10, and sometimes I just tap on it a little bit and wait till they move. Yeah, I don't think it's got there. It just took another bite. Sometimes they'll initially just bite it and do what they call gumming it.
Set them.
Got it.
I was like, what you waiting on, dog? What you waiting on?
Sometimes
nah, I'm messing with you.
Sometimes I like to wait till they get it deep, man.
Mm-hmm.
There we go. Probably another 15.
Mm-hmm. Okay, guys, we're going to try somewhere else, but let me give y'all a pro tip. Don't forget your key or you're going to have to jump your boat. Straight up. You gotta figure out how to hotwire your boat. Now, let me see if your captain done saved the wires or what did I do with these wires? There they are. So, in the event that y'all wanna learn how to hotwire your boat on OMC Evan route, you're gonna take the purple and then the red is basically gonna make a on position for your key, and then you'll hear the lights illuminate and you'll hear the beep. There it goes, lights illuminated on the console. Then you jump from the hot to the starter, which is the yellow and the red. Bam! Just like that. Just like that. But, oh, also, you gotta make sure the black and brown, because that's your kill switch, that's disconnected from the ignition. That way you could make a jump on in. See what I got in the bag of goodies. Oh, he came off. You saw that? Little bit.
Yeah, dog.
They're going to keep it, dog. Oh, Berkeley Gope jerk shad with a drop shot. I'll show you how ugly this rig is and they'll still bite it. Don't even matter. He going in a box. Got another one, guy. Little potato. Little tater. So it's the next day, and I'm heading to McLean Trailers to pick up some axles because, man, yeah, I don't even know what happened. But either way it goes, they broke. Life of a guide. So we made it here. Hey, if y'all need some trailer parts, call your boy Zane. He's over here off of I-10 location, McLean Traders.
So, yeah, okay.
So I fixed my ignition yesterday. I came to Red Wing Boat Company and saw Mr. Fred, and he hooked me up with the new cover new ignition, and everything was good. So I put that on in the parking lot, and then after I left, I drove about 100 feet or so, and guys, I encountered another problem. So I'm gonna put this down here, and I broke my axle. So I went to McLean Trailers, picked up two axles. Mr. Fred was kind enough to allow me to leave my boat overnight. So I'm gonna be in this parking lot and fixing this. So y'all stay tuned, fun stuff. Got the trailer jacked up. I'm gonna get up under the boat and start taking off these bolts and drop the axle down. I'm gonna take off the tires first so that way it kind of reduces weight. We're about to get on it, so y'all stay tuned. Fell on me and cut me. Hold on, I gotta go wash that. Look at that shit. That's the end, right? All in. All done. Alright, there's this jack stand up on the front. That's a wrap. That's a wrap. I'm happy. This part, the bracket that basically bolts onto the I-beam, bent, and it's so rusted out, it just kind of collapsed, you know, on both sides. But yeah, I'm gonna fix it up. There she is. Keys fixed, axles fixed, new hubs. So yeah, she's ready to go.